Hello viewers, my name remains Ajiboye Oladapo and I welcome you to the Global Tutor virtual class. I want to take this revision on mathematics and I want us to look at exponential equation. Now, exponential equation is one very important topic in YX syllabus, and I bet you there is no way YX will set their question that you will not see a question on exponential equation. But before we go into details of exponential equation, there are laws of indices that you need to make part of yourself. This law must be in your bloodstream. They must be part of you, because if you don't know the law, then it will be difficult for you to work around exponential equation. What are the laws? I'll quickly run through the laws. The first law says a raised to the power n times a raised to the power n. What it means is you are multiplying two numbers. They have the same base. Then you add up their power. You are multiplying, you add up the power. Number two, a raised to the power n divided by a raised to the power n. You are dividing number, the same base, so you subtract the power. That's number two. Number three, the law says a raised to the power zero, that is any number to the power of zero will give us one. Any number to the power of zero will give us one. So even if I have 1,000,000 raised to the power zero, it will be one. Number four, if I have a raised to the power minus n, a negative power, it's going to be 1 over a raised to the power n. To remove this negative sign, you have 1 over a raised to the power n. Number five, you have a raised to the power 1 over n. Now, this is different from this. The power is a fraction, 1 over n. But this one, the power here is minus n. So over here, you're going to have n root of a. Let me expatiate a bit on this. Now, if I have a raised to the power 1 over 2, it will be square root of a. If I have a raised to the power 1 over 3, it will be cube root of a. If I have a raised to the power 1 over 4, it will be fourth root of a. If I have a raised to the power 1 over 5, it will be fifth root of a, and so on. That is what this law 5 is all about, 1 over n. When it is 2, square root, 3, cube root, 4, fourth root, 5, fifth root of that number. That is law 5. Law number 6, a raised to the power m over n. Now, instead of 1 over n, it is now n over n. It will be n root of a, everything brackets n. So, this number here will become the power here. So, the last one, law 7, a raised to the power m brackets this will give me a raised to the power n times n. These are the 7 laws of indices that you need to memorize in order for you to solve exponential equation. These are the 7 that you need to memorize. Now, let's quickly take one simple example so you can see how we use the law. Look at this now. I have 2 raised to the power x equals 8. My question is now, find x. 2 raised to the power x equals 8. My question is now, find x. Now, this is 2, this is 8. Not the same base. But 8 can be expressed in form of 2, because 8 is the same thing as 2 times 2 times 2. 2 times 2, 4. 4 times 2, 8. Meaning 8 can be expressed as 2, 1, 2, 3. Raised to the power 3. So we can come down and say solution. 2 raised to the power x equals 8 is the same thing as 2 raised to the power x equals 2 raised to the power 3. So this 8 now is replaced with 2 raised to the power of 3. So look at it. The base are equal. If the base are equal, therefore, the power also will be equal. So x will be equal to 3. That is just what exponential equation is all about. You are using the laws of indices to what? To solve exponential equation. And this is just a simple example that I've just given you. Let me give you another example. Look at it. 0.25 raised to power x equals 16. Then I said, find x. Now, by now you should know how to change a decimal to fraction. For us to change this decimal number, 0.25 raised to power x to fraction, we're going to have 25 over this point becomes 1. This is 0, this becomes 0. So meaning 0.25 is 25 over 100. Everything raised to power x equals 16. So what do we do? 25 here 1, 25 here 4. So what we have is 1 over 4 to the power of x equals what? Equals 16. So how do we solve that? We can say we have this one is 1 over 2 raised to the power 2. Or, okay, don't let us go with 2. Since we have 16 here, we have 4 here. So we can quickly solve it and say 4 raised to the power minus 1 bracket x 1 over. So you remove it. This log 1 over. Then you remove it. So it becomes 4 raised to the power minus 1 equals 16. Now, I can express 16 in base 4 because 16 is 4 times 4. So meaning I can say this multiplied by this 4 raised to the power minus x equals 4 raised to the power 2. So what do we have? Base 4 equal, therefore minus x will be 2. So what do we have? We are looking for what? X. Minus x is 2, so x should be what? Minus 2. That is that. So this is the idea of exponential equation. Our main target today is to look at past question from WAEC and see how the questions have been set, and we see how we can solve them. Don't forget, like our video, share our video, and click on the subscription button so that you can see our future posts. I'm very, very sure the few topics I've been able to revise with you in this short time, when you see them in your examination, you will be able to solve them. Not should, because you have the benefit of watching a class over and over again until you understand it. Let's begin with past question. We want to look at 2013 question 2. 2013 question 2. Any student preparing for WAEC that does not have past question, does not really speak well of the students. Every student preparing for an external examination must have past question. 2013 question 2 is an OBJ question. And what does the question say? If 9 to the bracket of 2 minus x equals 3, find x. That's the question. 9 raised to the power 2 minus x equals 3, find x. How do we solve that? Solution. What's the question? 9 2 minus x equals 3. Now, this is 9. This is 3. 9 can be expressed in form of 3 because 9 is 3 times 3, which implies 3 raised to the power 2. So it means I can replace this 9 and have 3 raised to the power 2 brackets 2 minus x equals 3. So from the law, I will use this to multiply. So I have 3 raised to the power 2 times 2, 4, 2 times minus x minus 2x equals 3. You know, it's not written, but this, there is 1 here, there is 1 here, there is 1 here. That's 3 raised to the power 1. So it means if the bases are equal, then the power will be equal. So what do we have? Collecting like terms. This man will move to this side. So I'm going to have minus 2x will be 1. If this one moves, minus 4. So what do I have? Minus 2x equals minus 3. What do I have? I can divide by minus 2. So I have minus 2x divided by minus 2 equals minus 3 divided by minus 2. This will take care of this. Minus will take care of minus. So x will be 3 over 2, which is the same thing as 2 in 3, 1 number, 1 over 2. Any one in the option will be your answer. We are given 9 raised to the power 2 minus x equals 3. We are asked to find x, but 9 can be expressed in form of 3. And what is 9? 3 raised to the power 2. So what do? We open the brackets here, 2 times this 4, 2 times this minus 2x, then we simplify. The bases are equal, therefore the power will be equal. When we simplify, we got our answer. That is 2013 question 2. Now, let's take another question. 2004 question 14. 2004 question 14. Don't forget to like our video and click the subscription button. Don't forget to like our video and click the subscription button. Very important. Click the subscription button. The question is this. 2004 question 14. Also an OBJ question. The question says, if 1 over 4, 2 plus y equals 1, find y. 1 over 4 raised to the power 2 plus y equals 1, find y. How do we solve it? Just say solution. Now, 1 over 4 is the same thing as 4 raised to the power minus 1. Then 2 plus y equals, now from the laws, I said a raised to the power 0 is 1. Meaning any number to the power of 0 will give us 1. In this case, we are given 1. But the base here is 4. So I can assume that this 1 is 4 raised to the power 0. I've not changed the question because 4 raised to the power 0 will give me 1. So from here, I can open the bracket, minus 1 times 2. That will be 4 raised to the power minus 2, minus 1 times plus y, minus y, equals 4 raised to the power 0. The bases are equal, therefore the power also will be equal. So therefore, minus 2 minus y will be 0. This man can cross this side. So, or this man will cross this side. So I have minus 2 equals y. Therefore, you can say y is minus 2. That is the solution to that question. 2004 question 14. What are we asked? We are asked to find the value of y, given that 1 over 4 raised to the power 2 plus y equals 1. The only law that we brought here was any number a raised to the power 0 is 1. So any number raised to the power 0 is 1. In this case, we have a base of 4. So we assume that this one is 4 raised to the power 0, then we simplify. That is the solution to 2004 question 14. We are solving more questions. We are solving more questions. I bet it there is no way why you set their question and you will not see a question on exponential equation. So I'm trying to do this revision for you so that when you see a question, you will be able to solve it. That is 2014. So let's go to 2011, question 2B. 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 If you have a past question, it will be very interesting. Just go to the question and see. 2011, question 2B. This is the question. The question says, if 9 raised to the power 1 minus x equals 27 raised to the power y, and x minus y equals 1/1/2, find x plus y. Now, the questions we have been solving lead to a simple linear equation. But in this case, you see that you have two variables, x and y. It means this question is leading us to a what? A simultaneous equation. It's leading us to a simultaneous equation. So we have to prepare. Since you have two variables there, you should know it's leading to simultaneous equation. So let's solve it. Solution. 9, 27. Both of them can be expressed in terms of 3. 9 is 3 raised to the power 2, 3 times 3. 27 is 3 raised to the power 3, 3 times 3 times 3. That's 27. So you have 3 raised to the power 2, 1 minus x equals 3 raised to the power 3, y. You have not changed the question. What you have done is you have replaced y with 3 raised to the power, 9 with 3 raised to the power 2, which is still 9. You have replaced 27 with 3 raised to the power 3, which is still 27. So we can open the brackets and have 3, 2 times 1, 2, 2 times minus x, minus 2x, equals 3 times y, 3y. The bases are equal, therefore the power will be equal. Therefore, 2 minus 2x equals 3y. You can move this to this side, so you're going to have 2 equals, if this one crosses the equality sign, minus will change to plus, that's 2x plus what? 3y. So from here, what can we say? We can say 2x plus 3y equals 2. If you rearrange, call it equation 1. We are already given one equation here, that is x minus y equals 1/1/2. You can change this one quickly to an improper fraction. If you change it to an improper fraction, 2 times 1, 2 plus 1, 3, that's 3/2. Call it equation 2. Now, there are two methods in solving simultaneous equation. You either eliminate or you substitute. Substitution method or elimination method. Let's use substitution method here. So, from equation 2. What's equation 2? X minus y equals 3/2. Equation 2. I can make either of these the subject of formula. I choose to make x. So x equals 3/2. If this one should move, plus y. So I call this equation 3. I can now come and say, substitute equation 3 into equation 1. Please, anytime you use substitution method, if you make x or y the subject of formula from 2, do not substitute back to 2. You have to substitute to the other equation. In this case, it is equation 1. So what is equation 1? 2x plus 3y equals 2. Now, we have said that x is 3/2 plus y. So you have two brackets. What is x? 3/2 plus y close the bracket, plus 3y equals 2. So what do? We open the bracket. 2 times 3 over 2. These 2 will cancel these 2. So we'll be left with 3. It's like saying 2 times 3 over 2. So 2 cancel 2. So we're left with 3. Plus 2 times y. That is 2y. Then what's that part of the bracket? Plus 3y equals 2. So what do? 2y plus 3y. So you have 3 plus 5y equals 2. So what do? Collect like terms. So if we collect like terms, we're going to have 5y equals 2 minus 3. So 5y will be minus 1. Then 5y divided by 5 minus 1 divided by 5. This take care of this. So y is minus 1 over 5. That is the first variable, y. We still need the x variable. But we already said here that x is the same thing as 3 over 2 minus plus y. So it means we can say therefore that x is 3 over 2 plus, what is your y? Minus 1 over 5. So what do we have? X will be 3 over 2 plus times minus minus 1 over 5. So what do we have? X will be LCM 2 and 5, so you have 10. 2 in 10, 5. 5 times 3, 15 minus 5 in 10, 2. 2 times 1, 2. So your x will be this minus this, 13 over 10. Is that the answer? No. What did they ask us to find? X plus y. So you now come and say, x plus y is the what? Question. What is your x? 13 over 10 plus y. What is y? Minus 1 over 5. So what do we have? Plus times minus, 13 over 10 minus 1 over 5. What's the LCM? Between this and this, 10. 10 in 10, 1. 1 times 13, 13 minus 5 in 10, 2. 2 times 1, 2. So we have 13 minus 2, 11 over 10. The final answer. Or you put it in a mixed fraction, 1 whole number, 1 over 10. That is the solution to 2011 question 2B. We are given this and this, an exponential equation leading to a simultaneous equation. And in this simultaneous equation, we use the substitution method to solve it. Let me just find a way to go over the question. 9 is the same thing as 3 over 2. 3 raised to the power 2. 27 is the same thing as 3 raised to the power 3. So if we open the bracket, 2 times 1, 2. 2 times minus x, minus 2x. 3 times y, 3y. If the bases are equal, the power will be equal. So you have 2 minus 2x equals 3y. So if you move this to the right hand side, it will become plus. It was minus before, so it will become plus. You can now rearrange, bring this to this side and this to this side, and call it equation 1. Then we are already given one equation before, x minus y equals this, so call it equation 2. What we did to this mixed fraction is to change it to an improper fraction. So mixed fraction to improper fraction, 2 times 1, 2 plus 1, 3, so 3 over 2. Then if we take equation 2, this equation 2, I make x the subject of formula by moving y to the opposite side. So now, and I said something, if you are using substitution method and you make a subject of formula from equation 2, do not substitute back to equation 2, but rather to the other equation. In this case, you substitute to equation 1. So what was equation 1? 2x plus 3y equals 2. What is x now? Everything we have here. So we put it in the brackets. Now, what do? 2 times this is like 2, we take care of 2, leaving us with 3. Then 2 times y, that will give me 2y. Then what do we have outside of the bracket? 3y. So 2y plus 3y will give me what? 5y. result, and that's all about the question for 2011